Up to 22 veterans will take their life from post-traumatic stress, traumatic brain injury, and military sexual trauma. So Mission 22 offers free treatment programs for those veterans dealing with that. And we raise funds to put veterans through the programs through selling merchandise and through donations. So 86 to 87% of everything that gets purchased or donated goes directly back to those programs to help our veterans.
So anyway, my name is Buzz Bryant. I am the outreach director for the West Palm Beach VA Medical Center. What I do here now as the outreach director is I work in the communities to create relationships, create partnerships with businesses, with veteran service organizations. What I tell people is if maybe there was something at the VA that didn't work out for you, or maybe there was something at the VA for whatever reason, call me. Let me help you, or let me try to navigate you through some shark-infested waters. Because at times, sometimes it can be frustrating. I understand that. I do. Right now, I have an interim director at the West Palm Beach VA, and if I have to stop talking, tell me. At the West Palm Beach VA, who is an Iraq war veteran. He was a dust-off pilot in the Army, so he gets it. He served. He's the real deal. He's open-minded. He's an outside-the-box thinker, which is what I think we need. Times have changed. It's not the same old VA. We don't want that. We are trying to change with the times. We're trying to do things differently. We're trying to do things better. And I think we are. Like I said, I'm not saying that we don't have some warts, but I think if you go to St. Mary's or Palm Beach Medical or Cleveland Clinic or wherever, I think you're going to find some of those same frustrations as well. Real quick, so Spartan Pledge. So Troy had the opportunity, or SABO had the opportunity the other day to be a guest with the director and did an outstanding job, I might add. Did a very good job talking about something that's very important to us. So my last thing is when it comes to suicide prevention and suicide, probably a good portion of this room has been touched by it. You know, I've personally served with 4 combat Marines who've committed suicide over the last 12 to 15 years. Horrible. You know, it just horrible. You know, and we hear 22, and we hear 20, and the numbers are, listen, 1 is unacceptable. 1 it is bad. It's not, 22 is the number, I get it. And what Mission 22 does is awesome. They're everywhere. They're everywhere you go. They're doing wonderful things for our community. The Spartan Pledge is something that we are going to bring to West Palm Beach. We took our first big, big step this past week, and I think we're going to make it happen. So other than that, bro, I'm done.
So, I am 36 years old.
Yeah, right.
So, up until now, there's been a stigma that VFWs in the American Legions. They're just smoky old bars for the Vietnam vets. Unfortunately, that's untrue. And we're trying to build up a reputation. We gotta get new blood in here. Unfortunately, the blunt reality of it is, members are dying faster than they're joining.
Yeah.
And the American Legion does a lot of things on the national level, lobbying Congress for laws and all kinds of stuff. All that relies on the amount of members the American Legion has on the books and the $40 a year we pay to be a member, which isn't much. At the state level, we sponsor Little League, Boys State, all kinds of summer programs for youth. And on the post level, it's up to what the members do. So if we don't have members here that want to do anything other than sit at a bar and drink, that's all we're going to be. But if new members come in that want to do stuff, holding events like this, bringing in Mission 22. Sorry, I was yelling at a softball game the other day. We got to get the younger people involved. We got to get the stigma off the Legion, and we're holding events like this to get more people involved. So I'd like to introduce real quick our post commander, Dan Dalton.
I just want to welcome everybody coming to Post 268. I mean, we really appreciate this. I mean, this is for a great cause. So I'm glad for all the support. And like Mike said, we need to keep on doing stuff like this in this post. So we have a big hall, we have a kitchen. There's a lot of things you can do at this post to support the veterans, and it's here for you. So thank you for coming. Thank you for this great event. And whatever you guys need, just let me know. Thank you.
By the dawn's early light, what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets ran glad, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the
surface. So why you so why are you nervous? We on a mission to refocus, bringing awareness to all the non-soldiers. Pay close attention to my voices. Pay close attention to my voices. So here we are,
we're gonna take care of our own family because we take care of our own, not just over there, but over here. Let's get it done, all the way.
Make the Spartan Pledge. Give a little backstory. It was founded by Boone Cutler. He served, he came home. He was like a lot of us, lost in the sauce. Didn't know what was going on, didn't have a mission. And he came with this Spartan Pledge. What this Spartan Pledge is, as you can see, we have veterans from all parts of the world, should I say. No matter what creed, what sex, what color, don't matter. Because at the end of the day, we did what we did, and we are here for each other. So by us coming together and conducting the Spartan Pledge, we are pledging to ourselves that no matter how far, how dark we get in our little or big world, that we can rely on each other. We can pick up the phone and say, hey, I'm going through a dark place. I need your help. So that is the backstory of the Spartan Pledge. Before we decide to pick up whatever means it is, whether it's prescriptions, whether it's a gun, whether it's driving down the interstate going 235 miles per hour against traffic, drunk, whatever the case may be, before we decide to take our own lives, we have to contact one of our battle buddies. That's what the Spartan Pledge is about. We started young, pledging to the allegiance of the flag of the United States of America. We came on those yellow footsteps, raised our right hand, and pledged that we will solemnly defend this country. And now that we're out, and now that we're veterans, now that we're living amongst the community, we are pledging amongst ourselves that before we take our own life, we contact our battle buddy first. That's the Spartan Pledge. So, you guys ready? The Spartan Pledge goes as is. You guys can repeat after me. One second. Sorry, I get a little emotional doing this. Before I decide to take my own life, I will contact my battle buddy first. I will find a mission. And once I find that mission, I will give back to the warfighter community. I kind of freestyled a little bit, but that's pretty much it right there. Spartan Pledge, ladies and gentlemen, this is what it's all about. This is why we get together. This is what it's all about. Thank you.
Yeah.
Is running out, skipping lines, drop, asking yourself what you about. Look deep inside yourself. Are you the ice that melts or the force behind the fire? Are you the powerful voice or the one drowned by the choir? Are you the one who they love to hate or hate to admire? The summer or the buyer? Nah, you the one who walks through hellfire just to inspire. Let's go. When you feel like the world is against you, just hold on and continue your mission. When you feel like life is over for you, just hold on and continue your mission. When you feel like there's no way.